Welcome. My name is Tabe Masse, and I am the president of the board. Unfortunately, we do not have a microphone today, so I hope you can hear me. Thank you. Welcome to Total Praise, and thank you for being with us tonight for the opening concert of the Choir School of Delaware's 138th season. This is its theme, Amplify, Arts That Resonates. It works to bring to light revolutionary works of Black and Brown composers around the globe. This evening, we present a concert featuring framework inspired by the traditional Latin Requiem Mass, overlaid with sacred musical works by African-American composers. These pieces of music reflect the world we have experienced over the past year. The repertoire is filled with struggle, loss, remembrance, joy, and most of all, hope. While navigating the uncertainty of the COVID-19 pandemic, we have found one thing to be clear. Music retains its ability to unite people and be a conduit through which we learn to understand and support each other. Many of you are familiar with the choir school. But for newcomers, we offer you a special welcome, and we hope you will be inspired to learn more about us. The Choir School of Delaware combines a rich after-school program of professional level choral training and performance with academic tutoring and individual mentoring to provide a life-changing opportunity for children ages 7 to 17, many from the city of Wilmington's neighborhoods. Our after-school program, which is now entering its 25th year, provides aftercare support for children and families of the community. Your support through the purchase of subscriptions and concert tickets, as well as your volunteerism and philanthropy, ensures that together we will continue to impact lives and build hope for future generations in Wilmington communities. By the way, if you don't already have a subscription, you will have an opportunity to purchase one during this concert. We have a fantastic season lined up for you. Our next concert, Sound of the Season, will be on December 11th at the Winter Tour with the Museum Gardens and Library, where the choir school happens to be the artist in residence. More information about the concert will be forthcoming. Be sure to save the date. Thank you again for your willingness to come out tonight to ensure that the kids and the adult mentors in this intergenerational choral performance have the support that you bring here today. They've worked hard to bring you this wonderful performance. Turning our attention back to tonight's performance, please enjoy Total Praise, sponsored in part by the Delaware Division of Arts. Again, thank you for joining us.
Hello, my name is Ariane Carly Emerson. I'm the Director of Music and Operations here at the Choir School of Delaware. Thank you so much for joining us today. This program is conceived and modeled after Fari's Requiem, except each of the movements, we've substituted pieces by Black and Brown composers who were also writing in sacred idioms. This next piece is a more recent composition written within the last 10 to 12 years by a composer out on the West Coast by the name of Zainato Robles. We've loved this piece. It is a setting of the Veni Sancti Spiritus, which has been set so many times by various different composers. What is different about this piece is that it is an asymmetrical meter, meaning it's not in four, it's not in three, it's not in two, but it's in five. And so that is not as often that you find that. And the other thing that makes this piece really unique is that sometimes there are some groups that will be singing in five, some that will be singing in two, and some that will be singing in three, all at the same time. So there are a lot of different cross rhythms that come to be able to illustrate the text of the wonder of the coming of the Holy Spirit. So without any more elaborating about, this is Zainato Robles' Veni Sancti Spiritus.
Thank you.
Next in the program is a wonderful setting of a familiar hymn entitled Abide With Me. This is arranged by Moses Hogan, who left us certainly too soon in 2003. But what's really interesting about this arrangement is that it is not a spiritual. Moses Hogan has been best known for his spiritual arrangements or things that are also in the gospel style. So this is very, very, very different than many of his other works that are here. And it's a way that he uses to recontextualize the use of the hymn. So that's why we felt like it was a really wonderful selection for us to be able to present for you today. What is also really interesting is that Moses Hogan really subscribed to what we know as liberation theology. And so during the time of enslavement, when people were looking for hope and inspiration, they turned to faith. And the thought was that, my goodness, this guy upstairs is on my side. And so that was the lens that Hogan was using to recontextualize this piece. So you'll hear lots of effects in there when he is defying death, defying oppression. You'll even hear a lot of chromaticism as he pushes against what is the normal hymn that we would normally understand as a Bible. So enjoy Hogan's setting of Abide With Me.
Thank you.
What you just heard was a wonderful piece by a little-known Afro-Brazilian composer, Nunez Garcia. And the opening sounds remarkably like Mozart's Requiem in his Dies Irae that goes on. So you can see how the influences happened. We move on a couple hundred years, and the next piece is composed by Brittany Elizabeth Boykin. She is a newer composer on the scene. And this one is a setting of John 3:16. Most people who know John 3:16 might have heard the version by John Stainer, which is one of the ones that is done commonly. This one is in the same form of the Stainer, but is really calling on her roots in jazz and gospel. And so you'll hear all of these nice little beautiful, just harmonies that are just really spine-tingling and beautiful in this setting. John Francis.
Oh.
The next two pieces on the program are ones that are also really interesting. And as we think about our season Amplify, where we're amplifying the works of historically forgotten or excluded composers, the next two pieces come from spirituals, so back in times of enslavement. So during these times, having a piece of clothing was something special, particularly the nice clothes. So in a lot of the spirituals, we hear a lot about singing about shoes and robes and crowns and gowns, because it was a way to associate having something of value and being a person who was dignified and someone who was proud. So many of those pieces have those themes, and the next two pieces fall into that category. The first is a contemporary gospel setting by Tom Swiftfield, which has been arranged by Brandon Waddles, entitled I Shall Wear a Crown. And then the next piece is I've Got a Robe, which is quoting from the original spiritual, I Got a Robe, where this comes from, but it is also more contemporary, not quite as contemporary as the first one you hear, but a contemporary gospel style as well.
I
Our final piece in today's program is entitled Total Praise. If you've come to choir school concerts over the years, this is definitely one that you have heard before, and we've really enjoyed singing this over the years. So we thought it would be a great way to end this concert tonight. Thank you again so much for coming. If you've been moved today, we hope that you'll scan our QR code and come and volunteer with us. We're always looking for volunteers. If you can also, scan our QR code and make a gift to the choir school if you'd like to do that. You can certainly find one of us after the concert as well. And we'd be happy to let you know how you can get plugged into our community, because it is a community that matters. It is a community that is doing excellent work. And these kids are just absolutely incredible and are deserving of your support. So please come learn more about the choir school, learn more about how you can get plugged in. And thank you again for coming out.
do our time on Tuesday.